Winston-Salem man is dead following a tragic traffic accident. Charged with DWI in that accident is WXII 12 News morning anchor Tolly Carr. Bill O'Neill has more.
According to the police report, Tolly Carr and Fiola Wilson, another WXII employee, entered a marked work zone at the intersection of Burke Street, traveling west toward Hawthorne Road about 3:30 Sunday morning. As Carr approached Hawthorne Road, his pickup truck ran off the road and onto the sidewalk, striking a pedestrian. 26-year-old Casey Bokhoven was pronounced dead at the scene. Skid marks on the sidewalk showed the path taken by the truck. After hitting the victim, the truck continued into a building, damaging brick stairs and a metal hand railing. Tolly Carr is charged with driving while impaired. Investigators say further charges may be pending. Carr joined WXII 7 years ago. He was named morning anchor this past summer. Hank Price, general manager of WXII, made this statement in response to the accident.
This is a terrible tragedy, and all of us at WXII are devastated by it. It's affecting people's lives, people's families, it's terrible. We're a news organization, and so it is important, given that this does involve a public figure, that all of the facts come to light. So as they do, we will report them.
And that was Bill O'Neill reporting. Casey Bokhoven was a chef at Forsyth Country Club and had moved here from Sanford, North Carolina a year ago. His family says that he was at the Twin City Diner with friends and was walking home when the accident happened. According to a search warrant, Carr refused to take a breathalyzer test. A Forsyth County magistrate then issued the warrant for a sample of his blood. That warrant also states that Carr was unable to perform field sobriety tests, citing that he could not stand on 1 foot, walk, and turn. His blood alcohol level has not been released. The warrant also states that police detected a strong odor of alcohol on Carr at the scene. He told officers that he had been drinking earlier in the night. Bill O'Neill tried to get a comment from Tolly but was unable to. In other news this morning, President Bush is calling for yet more troops to Iraq and Afghanistan.